2015. Happy Evolve NJ Thursday, and welcome to another edition of the soon-to-be, in a few hours, one-year-old Evolution Open Mic. Thank you very much. And show some love to Burger Wild Out for opening its doors to us one more time. Clap it up. Clap it up. All right, as always, check it out to make you support the venue. Some of you have already done that already. Thank you very much for coming through. My name is Sean Battle. I'm your host for this evening. Whether it be 1 or 100, we still going to rock out. Thank you for taking your time out to be here. And if you are doing anything regarding social media or letting people know what's going on, be sure to use the hashtag EvolveNJ. Now let's act like there's 10,000 people in this room. When I say E, y'all say ball. E! Ball. So we got some people on the open mic list to go through tonight. Once again, hashtag EvolveNJ if you're tweeting about this or Facebooking about this. And of course, this is an open mic, this is an open space, this is a safe space. So please, make sure that you read the room and match the vibe of the audience with the vibe that you're going to provide. Y'all ready to continue?
Yes.
No. Y'all ready to continue?
Yes.
When I say E, y'all say ball. E!
Ball!
E!
Ball!
E!
Ball!
And J. I'ma give you another piece if that's okay. And then Jenny Williams, you'll be next up. Alright. Redemption. Why not this?
Without your energy,
balance is impossible. So, we're going to get on with the list coming up next to this day. And by the way, two pieces per person or any other performing art, you have at least 5 to 7 minutes. So, share what you need to. Coming up next to this stage, we have Jenny Williams. Clap it up, y'all.
I never perform my writing, I just write. Woo! And I'm gonna try to get through this without passing out. The first piece is my husband, the cameraman, it's his favorite, so. And I wanna say I'm grateful for this opportunity, for doing this, and I'm grateful for you guys listening. All right, it's called My Weave. I consider myself a strong black sister. An Afrocentric system, an embrace my culture type system. But many of my peers may think I'm hiding from myself with my European hair. Well, call it what it be, because I can only speak but for me. I do love my natural hair. A few times it's out to sea. I find it hard to maintain and stay up in this game, trying to stay fly so the brothers can say, hi, the natural. Soft as cotton. The hairs on a baby's body. I guess that's why when I put heat to it, it just holds long enough for me to hit the door, smell the fresh air. Seconds later, damn girl, what the hell happened to your hair? Now I have to go back in the house and start from scratch. Forget that, I'm putting on a hat. After work, I find myself at Kim's Beauty Supply placing my order because my natural hair can't take a little water. Yes, give me 2 packs of Model Mama Candy Roll 1B33. Oh yes, I'm gonna need a needle to tighten it to my head. Hours later, I feel so much better because I know it will continue to look good in any kind of weather. My weave. Maybe it's my way to cope, even my form of dope. I'm not hiding from myself or putting on a con. Get to know me and you'll see my personality is greater than anything I could ever put on. No, I have not forgotten where I came from. See, this is just part of my exterior. Get to know my interior, and best believe I'm gonna still rock my weave. All right. And this one is my favorite, personal favorite. It's called Interracial, Intercultural, Into Us. My world, your world. Together we clash to form our world. The newness of your touch, the unfamiliar tones in your voice, the scent of your motherland. Yes, we are from different worlds, and our similarities may be few. My beauty has become intoxicating. You're overwhelmed with desire, lust, and hunger. Come to me. I must have you. You need me? I need you. Submit to me. Submit to us. Sit down. Take a sip. I hurt, I cry, I laugh, I scream, I'm sensitive. I'm a gentle petal in a glass bottle on the edge of a cliff. I react to the wind, my hair is moved to the slightest temperature change. Love me, embrace me, I need to hear it, I need to feel it. Deep in my heart, deep in my soul, my spirit needs feeding. I hunger, I desire for the slightest drop, drip. Perspiration of lust. Move with me, sway with me, back and forth, we're in sync. Our heartbeats are in tandem. Each movement, each stroke, slide with me, and breathe. Release and disperse your love inside me. Spark the start of life. My life, your life, new life. Embrace me. Complete the cycle. Creation of life. Formed from desire. Knocking down stereotypes and barriers. We speak different languages. We evolve from different cultures. It can exist. It can thrive. Feeding on love from the heart, your heart, my heart, now a new heartbeat. We are interracial. We are intercultural. We have entered a
much for sharing.
Thank you.
We definitely appreciate you. I get ready for goosebumps. Miss Colorado, Jasmine Cooper.
Your heart is broken into pieces smaller than you could have ever imagined before your previous journey in love. For the roller coaster emotions and pains that come tonight stop you from sleeping and are only slightly soothed by screams called as pillows, yet you are shattered. That wine glass reminiscing, hourglass lost in time. Sahara Desert beneath foot, you are crushed. From desperately savoring fleeting moments of passion, if memories haunt the lonely passages of your atrium, if where there used to be flowers and candy, chocolate, moonlit dinners, phone calls that last for hours, and poetry, there is nothing. Come rest your weary soul here. Attempt to love you past your pain, kissing poetry into your temples and gently guiding you towards the light. You see, sunshine does something beautiful to hearts that have been trapped in the dark, and I vow to show you spring, even if I have to collect sunshine in jelly jars all winter. For you, my broken-hearted lover, I will do anything. Hours upon hours upon hands and knees, ruby red fingertips. Sacrificial love drips from these, yet no promises are made between us. I would not expect a wounded soldier to commit to another war. I will fight these battles for us both, picking up pieces as I go. You came to me, broken winged bird. Even your songs reaching melodies of treachery, but I will lend sing you lullabies and rock you to sleep, kissing poetry into your temples and loving you like ocean, wet, deep, and most important, expansive beyond what any eye can see. Yes, I will love you like the ocean, consistent and temple, predictable like the tide. I will love you endless, forever, gigantic, incredible, joyful, kind, adjectives for every letter of the alphabet, and over again, I will love you endless. Who? There is love like this, and you deserve to feel it surround you. All of you. Coddle you, and let it heal. I will work tirelessly at your cataclysm. I will not request help. I will find as many of the autumn old pieces that she scattered. I will stitch the pieces together, use Gorilla Glue for sweet honey kisses. I will turn your Humpty Dumpty heart into your Frankenstein masterpiece. You will no longer be heartbroken lover or broken with bird. Laugh, and you will. When winter comes, you will go south. It doesn't matter how many sunshine-filled jelly jars I collect on windowsills, and you are so, so sorry. But you must go, and I must wait for another broken-winged bird to land on my doorstep, singing melodramatic melodies of heartbreak, and I will kiss poetry into his temples and watch him fly south.
You have obliterated the verses pre-written and have forced me to be in my most tender. Your most vulnerable has forced me to take away the warrior and be not even a healer, not be not even a wizard, be not even a protector, but just stand still. Take in the ocean that surrounds me. Take in the ocean that wants to become one with me.
I appreciate all which you have longed to be, all which you have chosen to be. Slow, patient, calm, yet strong in your own way. When I speak with you, when I see you, when I hear that soft voice dancing in my ear, I do not think shy. I do not think hesitant. I think of a slow current, waiting for the right time to build, waiting for the right time to be as big as it wants to be, or maybe redefine what strength is, redefine what heart is. You are what you need to be. And if I am to accept you, if I am to be with you, as perfect as you are, I must stay away from format. I must stay away from rigid guidelines and allow this free writing process to be. Allow the fact that no draft will ever be final. We are a constant revision. Not seeing each other for a couple of days just to come at each other with fresh vision. Language, never dictating thoughts, but thoughts creating the language. But our ideals, but our mindsets, the seeds, be the gardens for which every word that is meant to be will grow into the masterpiece. Come tomorrow, October 9th, Evolution Open Mic will turn 1 year old. For constant support and the love that he's given to me and to others in this community. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. I'm Not a Poet himself, A.J. Song Warrior.
I'm really not a poet, you guys. Now, you said we have 7 minutes, right?
Yes.
All right, cool, time out. I'm trying to get a poem and a song in. I'm a poet for Christ, which means my poetry must be life. So I disguise my sermons as poems to bring the pulpit with me to each and every mic I write, because I know how it feels. You see, mom died when I was 3 and my father at 11, and it seemed like heaven robbed me of a family. I know how it feels to be passionate, group homes to foster homes, to begin to feel lonely, trust me. I know how it feels. But I'm here to tell you, it's time to say out with the old and in with the new, the basics. Alcohol isn't needed for happiness. New clothes can't buy you.
You got it.
New clothes can't buy your lifestyle. I'm here to tell you that sex is not needed for love, because God is only one prayer away in. No, he won't leave you. No, he won't lie to you. No, he won't misguide you. Yes, he'll make your enemies your footstool. Yes, it's a forgiving God. Yes, he will break the addiction. No, his word isn't fiction. No, he isn't an Indian giver. You see, I'm under the influence of J. Christ. Yes, the great giver of abundant life. Yes, he died, and salvation is a token of his love so we can be free. And whom the Lord set free is
free indeed.
Whom the Lord set free is
free indeed.
Whom the Lord set free is
free indeed.
So temptation coming from my left ear, blasted by the motivation coming from my right ear. Seeing castaways buried up there. See, you got the victory. mean I walk in it. In a battlefield with both eyes open. Close combat with the enemy, yokes not being broken. Gotta move with the kingdom up, get left behind. Behind enemy lines, watch out for roadblocks and idle minds. The enemy thought he had us. He thought he had us, my brother. My mission is not to judge you, but to love the hell out of you. So you can see that the God I serve is the only one that is truly right to die for you. See the homies on the block is like Casper when troubles go down. See the homies on the block are the reason why we let our dreams go, except for what our life drown. In the lake of, I could've, would've, should've, did things differently. Can't you see it's time to lose the crown and become that man of God he calls you to be? See, truth is, I came here today to talk about his story. One of love and compassion, sin and redemption, fact and non-fiction. Like Ronnie Braxton, and I can sing what we ask, so we ask God for more. And like a loving father, he rebukes us and then showers his love from the heavens to this very floor. Like disobedient children, we constantly disobey, and time after time, that has to remind us, this is the verse king, we can't have our way. So let's skip a couple chapters and watch the plot thinking. A couple thousand years of bondage and freedom, and we all still missing. The fact that he's probably tired of us taking his love for granted. Because whom the Lord says free is, whom the Lord says free indeed.
Next on the list, she runs the Open Words Workshop every second and fourth Tuesday at the North LGBT Center right down the street on Malmsey. And this is the first time I'm announcing her, not by her former stage name. She's dropped it. No longer Mary Jane. Please welcome.
Mary Jane.
Yeah, she dropped it. No. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jesslyn Blue.
Big round of applause, y'all. Tomorrow was amazing. being a man and being a black man. So thank you, Sean. Happy birthday to Evolving Jay.
Yes.
Thank you for having me. And on behalf of Asada, the Queen Asada, she's not here tonight, our sick compadre, coughing up a lung, hacking up, playing my mic, so the hot freestyle about that shit. But I'm not. But that's my bae. Thank y'all for coming out. We could not do this without you each and every Thursday. I know rent week gets so hard. I ain't paid my rent yet, but I got the money.
I just ain't ran past the mailbox
yet. So, but seriously, if you know someone that's being abused, you know someone that is being talked down to, beat up, slapped up, punched up, yoked up, call somebody. We gonna bring a lap around. I mean, we gonna bring a car around and disappear. But real quick, I'm gonna do something. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I'm gonna just go with the vibe. I'm a freestyle poet, or freestyle, just whatever. Let's see what I got. Can one of y'all please push the peroxide to the side? Pass me a gauze, but I can wipe under my eye. There's a bruise that's oozing, a bruise that's leaking. He left it, she left it, they left me bruised and beaten. See, I want to have a conversation with my mother. See, I cried the other day in my window because I couldn't get to her other side of her ear. I needed her to hear what I had to say, because she's in fear of what I have to say. She can't hear what I have to say, but I need to tell her about her man. I need to tell her about her man. I need to tell her about her man and the size of his hands and how they choked me up and they gathered my words around my throat collar. I can't speak, this man got me weak. Not weak in a good sense, but weak that he's my daddy and she allows him to seek me out like a woman on a bout, a bout for the strife. Do you understand? I'm not his wife. My mother is, but yet they gave me life. Yet they took my life. Yet they took my life. Yet. They taking my life. 32 years later, I'm here, and yet I can't even be my own savior. I am crying tears in a room where there's nobody listening. There's nothing but open windows and padded cushions. These cushions are not from Jennifer Convertible. But I converted myself into trying to think that I'm not hurtable. Yet I'm not hurtable. Yet, but I'm not hurtable. There's no audible left, and they can't hear my cries. They're wrapped up in paper and loose notes, and yes, swept notes that I thought was love. There's no love here. There's no love in this house. There's no love in this house. I don't even love myself. How can I allow someone to douse such flames on my spirit? So much flames on my insides. But yet he was my daddy and I thought that was inside. But yet he was inside. So let's talk about how my mother went outside. She chose to turn her head to the inside. What was going on? The inside of her home and these walls. They forgot me. I was the youngest of four, now the oldest of three. I had to go back and save my baby. She's 16 now, I've given her life. They found her with short shorts and high heels approaching my father's front door. I was long gone, I'm 4 feet and four hands, and I laid on my back for plenty of nights trying to understand. Was this my position? Is this my position? From man to woman, from woman to man. I tried to find an understanding on how my right hand would write a letter to say I'm sorry to my soul. Oh my God, I'm losing my throat.
Thank you. My mother was 14. My father was 29. When you do the rhymes, you do the time. My sister got caught up somewhere in the line. See, her age told the story, and that he couldn't lie. My father was 31. My brother was a child, but why? This man has been a pedophile, called the altar boy, touched, confused, and misconfused, dazed and abused. You don't know shit about my blues. You can't tell me nothing about my promiscuity, how my uterus and my fallopian tubes get used to me, how these babies have fallen out of me, and I'm not even strong enough to hold them inside of me. How dare you? How dare you think you know me? Call me a whore, call me blasphemy, call me what? Can you last as me? Can you last?
A fellow
leader of this culture. But when that time ended, I knew I needed to be more than a writer. I needed to be more than a performer. I needed to be more than some dancing ass monkey. October 9th, this year, I decided to follow the long words of a cerebral assassin, of a king of kings who once said, in life, you either adapt or you perish. That is evolution. That is revolution. That is change. I needed to be the change I wanted to see. I needed to be accountability through artistry. I needed to connect. I needed to form. I needed to express. I needed to be the express. This is the connect on express. This is evolution. This is how we evolve NJ. Evolve New Jersey. You see, this is about showing New Jersey is more than whatever butt of every joke in the mainstream. This is about evolving ourselves, it's evolving our state, it's evolving our country, it's evolving our continent, it's evolving our globe. This is about evolving our own consciousness, recognizing where we are falling short, recognizing where we need to step forward, we need to be forward, need to be out front. I need to be in the front. I need to be that leader. I need to be that boss. I need to be that wolf. I need to be that professor. But there were times where I was scared to do so. There were times where I was scared to be. There were times where I was scared to exist. Exist, exist, exist. But over time I knew, if this was going to be what it needed to be, I needed to be up front. I needed to be that leader. I needed to be that team player. I needed to be that artist, that maverick, that martyr, that activist. I needed to be just me. I needed to show that I am flawed, but forever in progress.